Thank you. So today I will talk about our work with Dimitris Papadopoulos and Babis Papamanthou, searchable encryption with optimal locality, achieving sublogarithmic grid efficiency. I think Tariq gave a great intro to searchable encryption. A quick recap. So in searchable encryption, we have a client who owns a document collection, and he wants to outsource this document collection to an untrusted cloud without losing any search capability. So in searchable encryption, we create an index, we encrypt the index, we encrypt the documents, and we upload everything to the untrusted cloud. Later, the client can send encrypted queries and take back the encrypted results. In searchable encryption, we have some unavoidable leakages in order to have efficient constructions, which are the setup leakage, the total leakage prior to the query execution, and the query leakage, which is divided to search pattern, whether a search query is repeated, and the access pattern, and the encrypted document IDs and files that satisfy the search query. So informally we say that the searchable encryption is secure if the adversary does not learn any information beyond the above leakages. So let's focus now more on the index. Most existing works, they store the index in this form. So the server, given a search query, can actually give us back the result. So he can actually jump to the first memory location that contains the first piece of the result, then to the second one, then to the third one. We define as locality the number of non-continuous reads for each query. So in this case, locality is 3 because the server performs 3 random jumps. So why we care about locality? Because according to the literature, locality is a very important efficiency dimension, especially if we want to scale searchable encryption for big data. So the problem here is that we can achieve optimal locality just by reading all the time the entire index, which is not efficient. This is the reason why we need to define another metric, which is called read efficiency, the number of memory locations that we read per result item. So in the first example, read efficiency was optimal, while in the second example, read efficiency is order of n. Ideally, for scalable solutions, we need to maintain both locality and read efficiency as low as possible. Can we achieve optimality in both terms? There is an impossibility result in Eurocrypt 2014, which actually tell us that we cannot achieve at the same time optimal locality, optimal read efficiency in linear space. Let's explore the locality-aware searchable encryption schemes. We have schemes that in order to achieve optimal or bounded locality, optimal read efficiency, they have to sacrifice and they have to blow up the space. In 2016, in Stock, we have a work from Asarov et al., the one-choice allocation scheme, which is the first scheme that achieves optimal locality, logarithmic grid efficiency, and linear space. In the same paper, the authors present an improvement. They propose two-choice allocation algorithm, which reduces the read efficiency, and they achieve sublogarithmic grid efficiency under the assumption that they don't have keyword lists in the datasets, in the dataset with size more than n to the power of 1 minus 1 over log log n. So in the next presentation, Ido will present an improvement of two-choice allocation algorithm. In our work, what we did is we combined the benefits of both worlds. In particular, we proposed the first scheme that achieves optimal locality, sublogarithmic grid efficiency, and linear space without having any assumption about the maximum keyword list size that we can support. Let's build some intuition behind the searchable encryption schemes with good locality. So let's assume that we have 3 keyword lists with size 4, 5, and 3. And let's ask a fair question here. Why we don't store these keyword lists in a way that we can retrieve them later, all of them, with optimal locality, optimal read efficiency, and having linear space? The reason is the following. If we access the blue keyword here, we don't learn information only about the blue keyword, but we learn information about the input dataset and the future queries. In particular, since we don't have enough space left and right, the server now knows that we will not have in the future any query with result size 5 or more. A second approach in order to solve this problem is to get rid of this deterministic allocation algorithm, and for each keyword to decide where it starts in an array of super buckets uniformly at random. So we can throw the keyword, we can decide the starting point uniformly at random, and we can throw the keyword list here. And we can see now that by doing that, the keyword list now have overlaps. And in particular, we can see that there is a bucket that the blue, green, and red keyword have like an overlap. This is promising in terms of security, but the question is, what is the maximum bucket size here? So using the same intuition, one choice allocation actually proved that if we set the number of buckets to be n over log n times log log n, then they proved that the worst case bucket capacity is 3 times log n times log log n, and we can see overflows only with negligible probability. So they performed the random allocation, they pad up to the maximum capacity, and every time that now that they want to actually access the red keyword, they have to read all the buckets with optimal locality and logarithmic read efficiency. In the second scheme, in the scheme of two-choice allocation, based on the assumption that there is a bound on the maximum keyword list size that they can support, they significantly improve the read efficiency, and the algorithm works as follows. We first sort the keyword lists. We start for the most frequent keyword list, and for each of them, we make two random decisions, and we decide where to store this keyword list based on the decision that minimizes the bucket load. In particular, in this example, for the green keyword, we will choose to store the keyword list in the second choice. Now, every time we want to access the green keyword, we have to read both choices, we have to read the buckets for both choices for security purposes. So this is what we have from the related work. We have a scheme which works without any limitation and achieves logarithmic read efficiency. We have a scheme that works in this region and achieves sublogarithmic read efficiency. This is the two-choice allocation. And our goal is to provide a generic scheme that achieves optimal space, optimal locality with sublogarithmic read efficiency. So we have to provide the solution to this particular range. How we did that? Our first step was easy. We used the analysis of two-choice allocation in a way that we set the parameters that now two-choice allocation works in a bigger range and still achieves sublogarithmic read efficiency. This is how we handle what we call small keyword lists. The problem is also trivial when we want to access huge keyword list sizes. Keyword list sizes that have size bigger than n over log to the power of gamma n. In that case, just by reading the entire index all the time, we can achieve sublogarithmic read efficiency. So the real problem boils down to this particular region. In order to solve this problem, we actually divided this region to two sub-ranges. In particular, we will focus in this talk only to medium keyword list sizes due to time constraints. But you can see the paper for how we can solve the problem for large keyword list sizes, since we're proposing a multi-level keyword size compression approach. So let's focus on the medium keyword lists. So our starting point was a paper from 2003 from Sanders et al. For offline two-choice allocation. What is offline two-choice allocation? We have m balls and 10 beams. Now for each ball, we make again two random choices. And we store the ball in both choices. After we finish with all balls, we run a max flow algorithm, which has the goal to minimize the bucket load. And Sanders et al. Proved that the maximum load is m over n plus 1 with very high probability. So, but this works only for single size keyword lists. So our idea was to use one offline two-choice allocation per size and then somehow merge. So let's explain how this works. Let's assume that S is the smallest keyword list size that we have to handle with medium keyword lists. We organize this in an array of super buckets, of M super buckets. Assuming that all the keyword lists have size a power of 2, we create another array for size 2s with m over 2 buckets, etc. And for each of them, we run an instance of the offline two-choice allocation. Let's assume now that this is the output of the offline two-choice allocation per size. And let's see how the merging works. We create this gray array here, and when we start the merging procedure just by storing the entire column here in the first super bucket. Similarly, we fill the remaining super buckets. The question now is, what is the maximum size of this super bucket? Because this is what will define the read efficiency. In order to see that, we define as ks the number of keyword lists with size s, and as bs the number of super buckets for size s. We know from the analysis of line two choice allocation that the maximum load will be for each size and for each bucket will be ks over bs plus one. If we take the summation and set carefully m to be n over log to the power of gamma n, we prove that the capacity of each bucket is at most log to the power of gamma n. But what is the catch here? The overflow probability for each bucket is not negligible, which is essential for the security of searchable encryption. In particular, it's 1 over BS. In order to tackle this problem, we had to extend the analysis of offline two-choice allocation. In particular, we proved new probability bounds for OTA, and we proved that the probability that more than log square n lists of size s will overflow is negligible. If we know that, now we can handle this overflowed list differently. In particular, we create one stash per size, and we store this overflowed list in these stashes. So if we do that, now we can guarantee that the maximum capacity of its super bucket is log to the power of gamma n, and the overflow probability is negligible. So how we access this complex index structure? For this keyword, we have to access two things in the gray array, the two choices of which are outputs of the offline two-choice allocation. And we also have to access the stash without revealing which position we want to access. This is essential. Otherwise, we leak information about the input distribution as well. So how we can do that? One solution is to read the entire stash. But this actually blows up the read efficiency. It requires log square n read efficiency. So this is not a solution. So the second solution was to actually create a newer RAM with the requirements that I will describe below and solve the problem. The requirements are the following. We need an ORAM that has optimal locality. We need an ORAM that has zero failure probability, since we will apply this ORAM only to the overflowed list, which are log square n elements. And finally, we want an ORAM with a bandwidth overhead small square root of n, small omicron square root of n bandwidth in order to achieve sublogarithmic read efficiency. We did that. We created an ORAM which meets these requirements using ideas of square root of n ORAM, hierarchical ORAM, and the amortization technique from Goodrich et al. One last thing is that we cannot use this idea for any size bigger than s, and the reason is the following. If the maximum size is bigger than n over log square n, then the stashes are starting becoming having size superlinear, which is like, and then we'll have overall superlinear index size. So this is the reason why we had to handle the keyword list which are bigger than this bound here differently, and this is why we proposed the large allocation algorithm in our paper. So let's conclude the work. In this work, we propose the first scheme that achieves sublogarithmic read efficiency. It goes closer to the known lower bound. In order to do that, we use the analysis of two-choice allocation. We propose our own approach for medium keyword list sizes, which is based on offline two-choice allocation. We proved new probability bounds from this well-known problem. We created a new ORAM that we are using in both for medium and large keyword list sizes. We don't have the time to cover it, but we propose a multi-level keyword size compression approach for large keyword list sizes. And finally, for huge, we just perform a sequential scan. As a future work, we believe that this problem is very interesting and intriguing. And an open question is, can we go closer to this lower bound? And the second, I think that it's very interesting for us is to try to extend this locality analysis for dynamic searchable encryption schemes. Thank you.